Welcome to another video on document splitting on SAP. When we activate document splitting for profit centers and segments, and if the system is not well prepared for document splitting, we start getting errors in most of the transactions that try to post financial entries. And this can happen anywhere in the process. It can happen in purchasing, sales, payroll, and so on. And this stops the business activity, which is not acceptable. And in order to allow the business activities to continue as normal, we usually activate the option of the dummy profit center in document splitting. In the video today, I will talk about the benefits and risks of using the dummy profit center and what is the right way to using this function. As I showed you in the last video, we maintain the segment inside the profit center master data. So every profit center is assigned to a segment. And if SAP is able to find the value of the profit center in the posting, it will be able to find the value of the segment. This is why from now on, I will only be talking about profit centers. When we activate document splitting for profit centers, we ask SAP to confirm that any financial entry posted is balanced and complete on the level of profit centers. And if SAP is not able to find the value of the profit center in any financial entry, then it will throw an error. This can happen anywhere in any transaction that's trying to post a financial entry. It can happen in a goods issue transaction in sales or in goods receipt in purchasing, and this will stop the business activity. In order to allow SAP to continue with the business activity normally, we activate the dummy profit center option. And here we tell SAP that in case the profit center is not available in the financial entry and there is no way to determine it, then SAP should automatically assign the values to a dummy profit center. And this will happen in the background, so the users will not receive any kind of notification or error or anything. Then we move to the reporting side. And as long as we have values posted in the dummy profit center, it means that all our profit center reporting is wrong, because the values posted to dummy should actually be posted to other profit centers. But SAP was not able to determine the correct profit center in the process. And here we have to do two things. Number one, analyze all the values posted to the dummy and start reposting them to the correct profit centers. This can either be done in the controlling module by using the reposting transaction or by actually reversing and reposting the original transaction to the correct profit center. And be careful that even if the balance of the dummy profit center is zero, it doesn't mean that the values inside have no impact, because sometimes we have values coming from different business processes that should go to different profit centers, but SAP assigned all of them to dummy, and these values balanced each other to zero. So in all cases, you need to analyze and understand every value posted to dummy. Step two is to understand the root cause. Why wasn't SAP able to determine the correct profit center in these processes? Why did SAP post to the dummy profit center? You need to understand the root cause and you need to fix it. Most of the issues we face with document splitting are related to incomplete master data. And this is what I will talk about in the next video. Now, I want you to go to your system and analyze the dummy profit center. Tell me what issues do you have, and I will do my best to include them in this playlist. I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to check the full playlist here, or click here to see the next video. You can also check other recommended videos up there. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.